Hey guys! Today we decided to do a video of us cooking a meal outside on the fire and the whole process that goes along with it. So I hope you enjoy. We wanted to do a video for you guys about what we would normally eat in a day. So many of you were asking about this. What kind of meals do you guys have in a day? We're going to show you one example of what we normally have for dinner. But right now it's lunchtime because to cook outside, which is what we normally would do for the evening, it's going to be too dark. So we're going to have our dinner for our lunch. This little wok is going to go outside on the fire, but to give it a protective layer, I'm going to put some mat on it.
This is our stove, dual stove. See that? Two burners. Highly effective. Prep this puppy. Mud on it.
It's not a puppy, it's a pot. Why do you think everything's puppies?
So this is just your everyday mud we got from outside of the garden. Mixed it with some water. That's how you make mud, people. Please excuse my socks with sand. This is cold inside. Not one, two. Ooh, this is pretty liquidy, this one. Just layer it on there. Oh yeah, I do. Make sure it's covering everything. Nice layer, so the pot doesn't turn black. And it's impossible to scrub it later. We just leave her out in the sun to dry. Today's a nice sunny day, so that should take just a few minutes.
What's on the menu today?
Roti and cooked eggplant.
Yay! We have a little purple eggplant.
Why is it so wrinkly?
Some little onion.
Yes.
And we have some garlic. It's a very simple meal, pretty much. Just some vegetables cooked and some spices. And that's about it.
Roti School, 2010.
Water equals water.
There's the flour.
The flour.
And the flour roller. What is that?
This is it. Milka.
That is. Oh, I forget how to say it in English. What is that?
This is Bhutmas Kutpet.
What does that mean? Oh, soybean. Soybean oil.
Soybean oil.
Soybean oil.
Soybean it.
It's the cheapest oil that you can get around here. Cooking oil. It's very tasty. He's making five rotis, people. Scoop some flour into that bowl.
It's about five, I'm guessing. Put some salt in there. A little bit of salt. A little bit of oil because you're not putting oil on the burner, but not much because Danica's can't have much oil.
Moldable, no lumps, but not too wet. One, two, three, four, five. What if they don't know how to make roti? Need to know. Man's gotta know how to make roti. My ideal man is a man who makes roti. Hand cake it, then swivel it around in your hand to become a little patty. The The real art of making roti is rolling them perfectly round. I'm told, as I can't do it. One dam.
Eggplant, as well as some onions and garlic. And normally we would put in things like ginger and tomatoes and chili peppers, which I love, and lots of other spices, but I was just getting over a sickness, so I can't really have a lot of spicy stuff. Actually, I should avoid spicy stuff altogether right now, unfortunately. So it's gonna be a little boring, a little bland, but it's food. We're gonna add a moolah in there, just fun, why not? Now the time has come to fill the bucket. We have our ingredients. We have our cooking oil. Spices, turmeric, only a little itty bitty of that. Salt, according to your taste. And some mixed masala, you can get that at any supermarket, pretty much anywhere in the world. And a plate for covering the wok. And don't forget the roti. There is the semi-finished product. Take this outside. Along with our, I forget what this is called. Hawa. And we cook the roti on this. Out to the fire.
Now we prep the fire. First of all, guys, it's hot up here. And it's only February. We got our doors installed, screen doors, and they left a whole bunch of wood shavings that we obviously collected off the floor. And saved that as a good fire starter because it works awesome. So I usually put that on the bottom of the stove. Leave that. We also had this pallet, this old pallet from our previous house. Our landlords let us have a whole bunch of firewood. We brought that here with us when we moved because we knew we'd be cooking outside. So we cut that up into little bits and we got a few pieces here today that we're going to use for the fire. Yeah, there's nails in it. Never mind. And we have our paper stuffs. All kinds of things that we collected. Burn. Ooh, it's really moldy. Shouldn't burn them, obviously, right?
Mold.
Does that kill the environment? Fire in general kills the environment, doesn't it?
I don't
know, people need to eat. What do you do? I don't want to touch it. It's pretty bad. It's deep, deep. Cut that with something. Keeping things even. I like things to be even. Do you not know this?
Yeah, I know that.
Seriously, who gives a back massage on only one side of the back? What's that? Wood in place. We're ready to put the stuff on there. A pot, nice and dry as well. What do you call this? PVC pipe? Sure, an old pipe. Probably used for plumbing of some sort. And we use this to blow on the flames, keep the fire going. Add the oil in there. cover that. Let that get nice and hot. We forgot two very important factors to this. A spoon to stir the vegetables. And tongs to flip the roti.
Tong.
Totally forgot about this. And now, seriously, just putting in like a tiny bit. Whatever that is.
Well, it is a yellow lid, it's hard to say.
It's a pinch.
A third of a teaspoon, maybe?
Nobody knows. Some masala. This is just like veg masala. It's got all kinds of stuff in there. That's why it's called masala mix.
Tell us the story.
Once was an eggplant that was really, really naughty. She got chopped up and thrown in the fire.
Don't be naughty.
Don't be bad, kids. Listen to your parents.
Nobody wants to be like the naughty eggplant.
Don't touch things. Go to bed early. Take a bath. Get off your phone, whatever you get in trouble with. Stop.
Don't touch things?
Or else, feel the wrath. Okay, this is it. Final roti. She's all done. I'll put a cover on that. It's good to go.
Thank you.
Get off the flames and just leave it for a few minutes to cool down anyways, and it still cooks a little bit more. So. Take these pieces out. Done.
How we made our lunch today, and usually every day for dinner, roti and some kind of cooked vegetable, and we're gonna eat it now because it looks delicious. Don't forget to like this video if you in fact liked it, and leave a comment if you would want to maybe say something about how we cooked it, or if you liked this video and you'd like us to make some more about meals in Nepal. We're not very exciting, but if you want to see more, then we'll put something together for you. And make sure to subscribe so that you can see more of these excellent videos. Alright. See you later.